60 days, 2 months, when LaMelo was brutally killed in the middle of Biloxi. I-10. Well, at least 40 or 50 or so law enforcement officers were around him. This was the insult to this for me. He was completely surrounded, ladies and gentlemen, by law enforcement. And don't mind telling you, ambulances were there. In regards to that, a four-month-old child had to be taken to a hospital in Alabama where that child died. That was LaMelo. And tomorrow, I understand, from some fairly reliable sources, to be 60 days, and of course it's Friday, and typically information like this comes out on a Friday. Because for the most part, it's a slow weekend. Really, you know, some of you guys, you politicians or individuals who play those games, really. And I don't know whether it will. I don't. The individual who shared that with me admitted that he had no inside information per se, but typically he said this is how it works. Either way, it really doesn't matter to me. Information is necessary as to why that baby was fired upon, the hostage. So we'll keep you posted. Bill Cosby's out. How do you feel about that? You all right with that?
I mean, I'm all right with that.
See the hands go all right with that. Yeah? No?
Not a lot. Oh, okay. Not everybody's hand is up.
I see a few hands from especially females that are not too happy about it.
No.
He's out on a technicality. Now, I've taken some positions on this way back when. I'm going to bring you up to speed. I think there is a teachable lesson here, though, that reeks of, two things. Number one, loose lips sink ships. And the other thing is making promises in the courtroom to this point, folks. There had been some settlements, meaning, you know, there were women who had accused Bill Cosby of taking advantage of them, and some of those women, including the woman who ultimately had him tried criminally, had received payment. Hush money. Sort of like what Donald John did with the porn star. Now, look, folks, you got to understand, with no admission of guilt. However, Bill Cosby came forward and he did some payments, several, actually, in an effort to quiet things. However, there was a need to charge Bill Cosby criminally. Now, I'm not defending him. I'm just giving you the backstory, just letting you know what transpired here. And then there was a comedian. I can't think of his name. He kind of dropped out. I've not heard from the comedian since. It really kind of made its way around.
Hannibal,
where is he now? Did we do a book or something? How I Brought Down Bill Cosby? Remember the little joke here that you were talking about? Bill Cosby's talking about this. He needs to talk about rape, blah, blah, blah. There was always these rumors about him. The guy hung out at Hefner's Ranch, you know, Playboy Mansion. There were women at the Playboy Mansion. A client of mine was a former Playboy bunny. And hopefully we'll get her on, we'll chat about that a little bit. But not that she had anything to do with Bill Cosby. So you had this this era of sex, drugs, and rock and roll. And that's exactly how you describe it. I was a part of that era. I saw it firsthand. There was a perception, a presumption that somehow or another, if you hung out in the entertainment era, backstage or otherwise, that you were cool, female or otherwise. I actually had one situation at the Municipal Auditorium in Mobile where, you know, I literally had to ask security to stop young women from coming backstage. Because it was not unusual was not unusual to have entertainers go in, and they'll pick someone out the audience, and okay, let them in, let them in. Before you know it, you've got a whole army back there. And you got to keep in mind there were a whole lot of bands. Now, I know Bill Cosby is just a single comedian, but he was part of that same kind of free love, sex, drugs, and rock and roll era. Now, it's hard for me to describe it for you guys, I think. Because you guys, the generations now, your generation, bro, you guys overdo it. You have a perception of how it was, but you don't have a clue as to how lax things were. There was no, there was no one checking you. You weren't being frisked at the doors. There was a general understanding when you went to concerts at certain locations that although there were things that were illegal, and I don't doubt the DEA was in full effect in there, because there were some individuals who were busted. It was not unusual to have the entire building smelling like smoke. Marijuana smoke. And if you went backstage, it got even more complicated. And in some cases, law enforcement was not allowed backstage, unless there was an emergency. Where are you headed with this, Rip? Where I'm headed is that during the time that Bill Cosby, was on stage, mostly doing stand-up, he was very, very popular, and by the way, I liked him. Still like him. He was part of that culture. I'm not saying he was indulging in the drugs, but obviously, I believe the women, he was indulging in the sex. And I don't doubt that some women got caught up in it. I'm not blaming them, I'm just simply saying now, folks. I don't doubt that some women were well aware of what a quaalude was and well aware of what marijuana was, and be it THC, acid, purple haze, or Valium, T's and Blues went around then. Certainly knew what cocaine was. Not a whole lot of people, though. The rich certainly did. I mean, it was a rich man's drug, you know. So here you have Cosby, turning the clock forward, Cosby involved. Now, there's some 50 or so women now. Even one, he still has a case out there. One 15 woman saying that she was raped when she was 15 years old at the Playboy Bunny Ranch. I became a little suspicious of all this when I'm seeing, 40, 50-something-year-old woman now coming forward. I'm not saying I don't believe them. I'm just simply saying I became suspicious. I did. And some of you did, too. And, of course, the Me Too movement was born. But the biggest thing is loose lips of sink ships and Bill Cosby. When he won the first time, didn't know how to shut up. He has a Donald John syndrome that overplays his hand. After all, he is, this is after the Cosby Show and so forth, he was considered as Mr. the Dad, and don't get me wrong, played it very well. And he was, before that, he was a dad when he had the Cosby kids and all. I mean, this guy, I don't doubt it, he really could have been African-American's first billionaire. Because I remember Bill Cosby from I Spy. You don't know anything about I Spy, do you? Bill Cosby was on, on television when there were only two or three African Americans on television. I mean, outside of, what was his name, Winchester? I think it was Winchester with Jack Rochester. Thank you very much, Jack Benny. You've been doing some studying. And of course you had Amos and Andy, but I mean in a integrated environment. I mean, he was one first in a police kind of movie like this where he was not playing Stetch and Fetch It. You got me? He wasn't a spy. He was a spy, and he was the second guy, and he was a cool guy, and he
wasn't playing it for comic relief.
Oh no. He wasn't just being funny either. So he goes way, way back, folks. We're talking early 60s here. So now, turn the clock forward, and so he cuts this deal with Castor, who was the district attorney at the time. And because Castor wanted some, it was a civil case, and Castor wanted him to testify in that case. And so he said, well, look, if you can just come forward, we won't try you for any criminal charges. Just want you to be honest. Now, at that point, Bill Cosby, like an elitist, and he was arrogantly, he arrogantly thought that he could walk in there and say, look, it was sex, drugs, and rock and roll, and I only gave her what she wanted. That's all I did. I just had to give her something to relax herself and gave her a Quaalude. Now, on the surface, ladies and gentlemen, you realize you can buy Quaaludes. In other words, they're downers, but they have to be prescribed. Any drug is illegal if you don't have a prescription. Or if you say to someone, I'm going to let you have this drug. I got a prescription for it, but I give it to you. You just did a drug deal. I don't care if it's your mama. If someone comes along and they have one of your pills that you gave them, even if they ask for it, you did a drug deal. I'm just saying. So Bill says, well, yeah, I'll testify. I didn't rape these women. I didn't do it. I just did what I knew they wanted me to do. They were upstairs in my boudoir, and we were having some drinks. By the way, Cosby didn't drink, and according to him, didn't indulge. And so, you know, I just gave him a little something to relax. He had made some comments about Spanish Fly. They liked this, and while they were
unconscious,
subconscious, because sometimes you're not completely out, I understand, he took advantage of it. And yes, that's rape. You don't have to call Rip Daniels and say, Rip Daniels, look, you're belittling this. No, that's rape. Typically, rape is described as something that is brutal. Actually, it is by force. By force does not mean that you've got to have bruises and scrapes and your panties have to be torn. By force means that you're incapable of defending yourself.
You did not consent.
And any man who enjoys it that way is just a sleazeball to me. You like that? You do that? That's just as an aside. Look, she's drunk. She's unconscious. Ah, yeah. This kind of stuff did impeach Donald John, but dude. You know, he's the kind of guy that... But anyway, Cosby did that. Sleazeball. Sleazeball. And so he was accused of doing it. His defense was, while he was giving testimony, honestly, was, I only did what she wanted me to do. She knew I had the Quaalude. She knew I gave her the pills. She knew she was going to be relaxed, and she certainly knew that I was going to.
Didn't slip with the pills. Got it for it and gave it to her.
So he said some things. You have some of his stuff?
Just him on getting out.
Yeah, no, I don't want that. Yeah, we'll get that later. And that's a pretty good imitation of it. Now, we got to do a little bit more. So add some more cheeks. Add some more cheeks. You got to sound like you have a big nose and perched lips like this. You got to perched lips. Well, so he comes out and he says some things. He admits that he gave some Quaaludes, and he admits that, okay, he did whatever he wanted to do with them.
The deposition for the civil case.
For the civil case. With the guarantee, immunity, that he would not be held criminally liable, because Bill Cosby is under oath, ladies and gentlemen. He took it as an affidavit. And he's saying this thinking that, okay, he's in the right, because after all, she allowed it. I didn't rape her. Right? So I can tell you the truth, honestly, what happened and then what I did, but the point is that she came here for that. That's why she was up here. Well, that information came out later, and charges were filed. And it's ironic that charges were filed from the very woman who had received some payments and was working with Bill Cosby. I'm just saying. There were those of us who went, what, huh? Yeah, she continued, she came back to his place.
Again. Damn.
Who does that?
Constand.
Well, Constance did, and then Constance turned the tables on him after receiving payment, even, and said, okay, yeah, well, I'm going to file some charges because time had not ran out on her. In other words, there was a statute of limitations there on some of the others going back to sex, drugs, and rock and roll. This is a little bit something more recent. Now, here, at the time he was coming up on 80. What is he, 83 now? Went in when he was 80. He started to fight somewhere around 78, 79. Going blind. But still, he's a man. And he is still a sleazeball. Like it or not. You would think his karma would automatically kick in. He lost his daughter viciously. And his son killed viciously there, robbed, killed. The two kids go. You would think, in other words. And then, of course, he has Camille, his wife. Lovely silver fox that she is. Didn't make a difference. He was caught up, like so many others, into that sex, drugs, rock and roll, and I'm the entertainer, and I'm bigger than anyone else. And people should circle the wagons around me and fall on their sword if necessary, like the ex-president. His belief the same. Celebrity types have that kind of concept. So the long and short of it, so Cosby now found guilty. Second time around. First time it was a hung jury. And after that first time, I had opportunity to visit or to see Bill Cosby at over Xavier University in that lovely gym there. And I came back, I shared that I did. There were those who were boycotting Cosby. I wasn't, I thought, okay, I'm going to watch the guy. Good performance. However, I admit it on this show, he could not leave it alone. He wanted to thumb his nose at those individuals who had brought, who had accused him falsely in his view, and it was a hung jury. Ha ha, hee hee, I got away with it. You can't do that. You can't look a gift horse in the mouth. No. You know why?
You could take him back.
He'd grin at you. Hey, take it back. You ever seen a horse chew ice, by the way? It's
no.
The damnedest thing. They really can't chew ice. Anyway, so he's over there. I watch him, and we come back, and lo and behold, the new DA, for the sake of getting elected, and I do mean for the sake of getting elected, Kevin Steele, this guy, files criminal charges. We're not going to let this Negro, yeah, you heard me right. We're not going to let this Negro get away with that after all. I mean, he just raped a white woman. You kidding me? Not one, not two, but we can't count, isn't it? Can't get away with that. Me Too movement's now feeling, and by the way, as it should. Kevin Steele saw this as a way that he can get elected, and he said, look, you like me, we're going to file criminal charges, and he did. And then he got away with it. And his mind, Cosby got away with it. Well, I'm just going to have to file again. Is Kevin Steele still there? The DA? You don't know? I'd be curious to know. In and around Montgomery County? No? Well, just check. So Cosby then goes back before the jury, and the jury says he did.
He is.
Sentenced him to, 3 to 5? Something like that. Maybe 7 years. He's 80 years old. And he's going wearing that cyber jumpsuit. Goes right in. So now he's out. Why is he out? The Supreme Court says, well, because it was not due process. He was given immunity, and no matter what, that should have been respected. In other words, he was told that he would not incriminate himself criminally. That's what he was told. He was told, no matter what, as long as you be honest, as long as you say what you did, it would not be self-incrimination on a criminal matter. Arrogantly, Bill Cosby believed that. And because he felt that Bruce Castor was in fact a DA and could give that kind of guarantee. And the Supreme Court just ruled it was. You realize this was not written down, ladies and gentlemen. There's nowhere we have found that immunity, or as Castor said, you are immune from criminal prosecution. Which is why Kevin Steele decided, okay, well, you know what? It's not written down anywhere, then I can do it. Now, it was generally expected that the last DA would share with the following DA what kind of guarantees, what kind of promises could make. The question was whether or not the first DA, Bruce Castor, could do it. Well, guess what? He could do it. Can a DA take a deal? Yeah, he can. Does he have to write it down? No. Should he have? Yes, in my view.
Cosby's attorney should have expected it.
Oh, you gonna put that in writing, Mr. DA? That should have happened. Didn't happen.
So, with that said, Kevin Steele takes him to court. Twice.
Yeah, realize it's not double jeopardy because, after all, the jury was a hung jury. There was not a... In other words, there was no result in that case outside of, well, we can't decide. It's a hung jury. And Cosby foolishly thought that, okay, all was well. Well, I'm free. It's a hung jury. That's just as good as winning. As long as I don't lose, I win. It's a lot of something like a stalemate, Ishmael. Well, he was wrong there, because let me just say, Kevin Steele was not going to let this keep him from winning re-election there in Montgomery County. He certainly didn't, so he just stacked his jury. And then he called in eight or nine of the women who accused him of doing the same thing. And the judge allowed it. All of that was really shady to me, by the way.
They had no evidence whatsoever to give in the current case outside of giving some information as to what they experienced with one Bill Cosby way back when. Ordinarily, the judge would not have allowed that. But he had like six or seven of them come in, and it was like, okay, here's what he did to me, and he gave me this, and blah, blah, blah. This before a jury who was supposed to hear the evidence. These were accusations. It's careless. But influenced the jury enough, and so Cosby, voila, found guilty. Cosby was PO'd. He said a few things he shouldn't have said on the way out. He knew there was an appeal. He should have kept his mouth shut. He didn't listen to his attorneys. Again, that arrogance pops in. You know, that pride goes before the fall kind of thing. And so, needless to say, he goes and carts off to jail. 3 years later, the Supreme Court determines, you know what? This was not due process. The man was told that he would not self-incriminate himself. It's like he had given immunity.
Made a deal.
He made a deal. And the prosecutor, don't get me wrong, it didn't have to be Bruce Castor, but at the prosecutor's office of Montgomery County, he was supposed to stick to that. If I tell you you've got immunity, you got immunity. Right? Well, they didn't. And Bruce Castor, by the way, the one who defended he was the worst attorney that was defending Donald Trump. Here he is. Here, see this guy in the pinstripe suit? That he like a sleazeball. And it just looks like one of those good old boy kind of prosecutors who, you know. But so the Supreme Court said, well, look, the immunity was given by that office. The office gave it. And you've got to stick to it, and so therefore, the incriminating information that was given by Bill Cosby should not have been considered criminally, and your office, the District Attorney's Office of Montgomery County, had no business filing charges. And not only that, you will not be able to file charges ever again for this matter. There's not going to be a retry. You're not going to retry it.
It's over. Bill Cosby walks out after losing 3 years of his life. I can't wait to see him in concert. What? Does that bother you? Okay, you can take spying by mine. Because that's going to be my question on Facebook. Will you go see him? I guarantee you, coming out of the jail, he's got to have some good jokes. And his jokes are always clean, bro. He never cursed, never used the N-word. Always clean, but usually family-style jokes. Usually talked about his own family. Sometimes a little self-deprecation. Even family self-deprecation, you know what I mean? But always, you can relate to his jokes. You really can. And I for one, never stopped playing his jokes. It's still funny. There were those who did him like you did R. Kelly. And I didn't see it that way. I didn't. That doesn't mean that I don't empathize and sympathize with the women. I believe them. Oh, I believe. Do I think he's a sleazeball? Yeah. I think he's as much a sleazeball as a former president. I also feel this, and ladies, I'll take your chastising. It's okay. You bear some responsibility now. You lay down with dogs, you wake up with fleas. You know, and I'm not saying that it's excusable. I'm not saying that, but doggone it, you can't trust everybody, bro.
Nor should you.
Just can't do that.
By the way, guys can't trust everybody. You ever went fishing and caught crab? You don't know what's out there, bro. You throw your hook out there, you drop your net, you don't know what you're going to pull up. You don't know what you're going to end up with.
You don't.
And then came AIDS. We're talking 1980s here. Jeez, really? I mean, don't you care more? How do you have a private part and everybody takes a part in it?
Yeah, don't touch my private parts.
And everybody around town know. Ain't been that private. And we gotta tell our children that because that, look, let me tell you, there's a lot of young people got mixed reactions, but. Yeah, would you see him?
Would
you go see him if he put on the show?
Nah.
You wouldn't?
Nah.
Is it solidarity?
No, not really. I just...
You never liked his humor?
I never saw myself wanting, like, clamoring to go to see Bill Cosby live. You know what I'm saying? Like, even with the old films, old stand-up films and stuff.
Really?
Yeah, it never really struck me. Like, I was a Heathcliff Huxtable fan more than a stand-up Bill Cosby fan.
Boy, had you seen him stand up? He didn't stand up, by the way. By this time, he's sitting down.
Yeah, he sat down.
That was my second time seeing Bill Cosby, and it was... It's humor. I look, folks, I don't like going to see comedians who always use the N-word. I tolerate the B-word a little bit in certain contexts. But N-word, once they do the N-word, I remember walking out on Wayne's, and you just don't have to. You know, I've reached a point whereby anyone who would do that, actually, in my view, and I'll tolerate it. But I think... I don't think well of them because they don't, men, especially African Americans, because what they don't realize is that they're giving license to someone to call their mama a nigger. You know what I mean? You got to put it in that context. I don't like it. So, but Cosby was, I could tolerate his humor because his humor was more about family and so forth. And I can identify with it. I really could. So yeah, I'm going to say it. All right, yeah, we're going to open the lines. We'll let you weigh in. I don't have a problem with that, huh? But there's a bigger story here, in my view. Bigger than Bill Cosby, and bigger, unfortunately, bigger than the women who were raped or molested. It is the story of the Justice Department allowing the DA to do that without recourse. Steele is still there. The Supreme Court ruled that he should not have actually criminally charged this man, and Bill Cosby should not have been found guilty. This should not have happened. Still knew it shouldn't have happened. Is he recourse? Is he going to be disbarred? No. The Supreme Court is powerless to say, look, you know what, Steele, you Kevin, you weren't supposed to, you knew there was immunity. You knew that your predecessor had given this guy immunity. It came out in the court. He decided that he was going to ignore that for political reasons. And there has to be some recourse when a prosecutor does not do what a prosecutor is supposed to do, or when he is selective as to what he does, driven by politics. I guarantee you this happens every day. Every day in these United States, there's a negotiation. And I've seen it. I've heard it firsthand. There's a negotiation, you get some poor sap that will go in there and do a plea deal for a crime he didn't do. Or, for that matter, will come in and testify against another individual for immunity. Or testify about something he doesn't even have a clue to, but will lie just to get time off. Probation. Get out of jail, out of the penitentiary. It happens time and time again. And look, folks, if I do nothing else on this show, we need to not just talk about Bill Cosby, but the power of prosecutors. By the way, we're still waiting to hear from the Harrison County prosecutor regarding LaMelo. One dear friend of mine who died recently, Conal Corona, as honorable as he was, he understood just how important that office was. There's no doubt about that. One William Martin, now deceased, used to work for him. And the two had a very strong mutual respect. But all of them were just very candid, almost raw kind of guys. Of course, William Martin was more raw than Tony Hawk.
I don't know how William Martin made it through a courtroom without cursing, you know what I mean? But he did. God bless it.
But what I learned from each of these individuals is that the powers of a district attorney, vast. They are more powerful than a governor. Particularly when it comes down to deciding a man or woman's life. It's just all in the presentation and how good of a trial lawyer they are. Or how they wager what they have. And it has to be an honorable profession, or this will happen. This will happen. Do I think Bill Cosby guilty or innocent? Well, he was found guilty. Wasn't supposed to be. He's self-incriminating. It was self-incrimination. He admitted what he did. I think what he admitted, in my view, was in fact rape. Ain't no ifs, ands, or buts about it. But the reason why you call a judge your honor is because you expect honor from that judge. And you expect them to act honorably. But every jurist is expected to act honorably, and that's not what happened here. And I guarantee you it happens every day in these United States, because there are some folks who are so drunk with power they cannot give it up. And whatever it takes, send some poor sap to jail for 3 years, some 80-year-old man to jail for 3 years, you know, or send someone to the gallows, to the gas chamber. After all, I'm going to get elected. Or just simply fire upon a car sitting in the middle of I-10 and say, I got my man, knowing that there's a 9-month-old in the car. There are people who are in high places and authority who think like this, and there has to be some recourse, bro. There has to be some recourse.
For sure.
You can't take 3 years from a man's life or take a baby's life and there's no recourse. Talk about due process. Sorry, my bad. He wasn't supposed to do that. I guarantee you Cosby's going to sue the Montgomery County Board of Supervisors, or whoever they are. Governors, I don't know. Whoever they are, they should be. And I would hate to see what they sue them for, and probably will have to do a settlement, because you realize that suit is based upon the amount of money that Bill Cosby would have made had he not been in jail for 3 years. This philanthropist is probably going to make out like a fat rat. However, loose lips sink ships, and he might just ought to not look that gift horse in the mouth and leave it alone. We'll be back.
America, we heard you loud and clear. You asked for better beef. That's why Walmart chose me, Bob McLaren, to provide their beef. You see?